Hi, my name is Emil. I'm a founder and CEO of Tomorrow Bio. And today I'm talking about how pricing of cryopreservation changes over time. Now, when people sign up for cryopreservation, they basically have two main price points: a monthly membership fee, in our case, somewhere between 25 and 50 euros per month. And then at the time of death, there's a one-time fee that pays for all the cryopreservation and pays for the money that is being put aside to pay for long-term maintenance of cryopreservation. That amount for whole body patients is, for example, 200,000 euros. Now, in the past, cryopreservation, it's a topic that has been ongoing for 50 years. Prices have increased over time, right? This amount of 200,000 euros wasn't always 200,000 euros. We haven't been around for long enough to increase the prices, but other organizations over time needed to increase the price. And of course, that's quite normal in quotation marks, right? 50 years ago, the sticker price of a burger was significantly lower than the sticker price of a burger right now, of course, due to inflation. Now, a typical person who signs up for cryopreservation, at least in our case, and this is kind of the case with all organizations, signs up somewhere around 35 to 40 years of age. Some also at 25, some also, of course, at 40, but that's kind of the ballpark. Now, they sign up at that point for a procedure that they hopefully will not need for many, many decades. So let's say someone signs up at 40, hopefully they're not going to need us for at least, let's say, 40 or 50 more years. Now, you sign up today, you sign that, once you're cryopreserved, you would pay 200,000 euros. And it's very important to remember, those 200,000 euros is just the current cryopreservation minimum. It's the amount that you would need to currently pay should you die tomorrow or next week or, soon. It's not necessarily the amount that you would need to pay 40 years down the line. The cryopreservation minimum at that point might have changed, and now it's 300,000, for inflation adjustment, for example. Now, our hope is, and not only our hope, but something we actively work on, is that A, over time, due to effects of scale, more people signing up and the cost now being divided by more people, we would not only keep that price stable, but maybe also bring it down so that, 20 years from now, the sticker price wouldn't be 200,000, it would be 150,000 or 180 or 190 or at least some amount smaller than 200. Of course, we cannot guarantee that at all. It's very difficult to predict what will happen in 20 years down the line, how inflation will develop and so on. And of course, not only how inflation will develop, but also what new technology will be possible, where then, maybe cryopreservation is much, much better, but also slightly more expensive. So first of all, it's always important to keep in mind that if you sign up today, for example, with an insurance funding plan for those 200,000 euros, in an ideal case, you don't go for that minimum, but you go a bit higher to then account for example, inflation happening over the next decades that would still then allow you to just fund your cryopreservation from that original amount. Now, some people, of course, go for that minimum, right? They just sign up with the membership fee and then they sign up for a 200,000 euro insurance policy, hoping that, inflation doesn't impact the price that much, or that they will make money in the future to supplement that 200,000 euro amount and so on. But of course, none of that is, necessarily super guaranteed. So A, we would always recommend to go slightly higher in that initial funding amount. Of course, that's totally your choice and we're not forcing anybody, but it is generally a recommended course of action. The second point is, when we talk about inflation in cryopreservation, it's not necessarily CPI, which is the consumer price index. That's kind of when we talk normally about inflation, that's what we're talking about. It's a basket of different items, food, gas, energy, and so on, that on average someone is buying, and how the price, the average or the price of that average basket has increased over time. Now, in cryopreservation, of course, we should talk more about a cryopreservation-specific inflation, or CSI. Now, that includes basically four main points or four main costs. One, of course, is the cost of liquid nitrogen. Liquid nitrogen needs to be constantly refilled, so the cost of liquid nitrogen is an important point. Then is the cost of personnel, so salaries, right? Like someone needs to maintain the facility, someone needs to make sure that the liquid nitrogen levels are always safe and sound, and so on and so on. It is one part rent. The cryopreservation facility is usually handled by another organization, not by the patient care trust, but by another foundation, that at least in our case, how we do it. And last but not least, that facility needs some amount of utilities, you know, standard utilities, gas, electricity, water, and so on, which also needs to be paid from the patient care trust. That, of course, is not exactly the same as the standard consumer price index-based inflation. Slightly different. Might be higher, might be lower. We hope that it will be lower than consumer price index inflation. But of course, we can't guarantee that either. It is possible, even though, again, we're doing everything that it will not be the case, it is possible that over time, at some point, we need to do inflation adjustments, basically increasing our prices to handle inflation. Now, if that is ever the case, and soon there's going to be like a policy that we're going to announce publicly, if that's ever the case, currently we're thinking that we do it in the following way. I know that in other organizations in the past, people have kind of been a bit irritated if there's a price increase, you know, from today till tomorrow, and suddenly the amount of cryopreservation funding that you have in insurance is suddenly not enough anymore, right? And then theoretically, if you would die tomorrow or like next week, right, then the amount that you have saved or in your insurance policy might not be enough to actually be cryopreserved, which of course I can understand that this is a bit irritating. And by the way, don't take this video as any indication that we have any plans to increase prices at all. We don't. This is just a very, very early start thinking and start talking about this topic, but no concrete plans at all. So on one hand, apart from, again, trying to, you know, bring costs down rather than increase them, we would, if we see on the horizon that we might need to increase prices, we're going to announce that very, very early. 12 months, 24 months, even maybe if we can earlier than that, not exactly sure yet what will be practically feasible, but that is at least a goal to increase it in the future so that people can have time to adapt to it. The second thinking is that we would always increase prices for new members first. So for people who still need to go through this whole procedure of signing up for insurance, for example, where they then from day one can plan with that, where they go to the webpage, they, you know, immediately see, okay, so this is the new price, and then they can plan with that. And then always increase for our own members who have been members many, maybe for years, if not at some point decades, increase their prices then later. And there might be slightly more complex calculations and complex policies of how to adapt to that. So for the time being, and not to go too long on this video, first of all, we would always suggest to put slightly more money aside than is currently needed. Just remember, the amounts that we have are the minimum that is would be required right now. Second, long-term planning, we will try to announce it as early as possible, and it might be possible that at some point we need to increase the prices. So what you can do, put more money aside and then stay in active contact with us, and we're going to announce it as soon as possible once we know that something might happen. And then, of course, we're happy to help everybody try to find solutions for that, try to find new funding methods and so on. All right, so if you want to learn more about this topic, or at least this kind of sector of topics, check out our video on funding plans. And of course, if you want to discuss this topic with us in person, reach out at any point. Just go to tomorrow.bio or send us an email. We're more than happy to talk to you one-on-one as well.